So in terms of your playing, there's a dynamic mix of cleans, heavy chunk, and shredding in your music. How does the BC Rich, especially your signature, how does that help you get all of those sounds?
For me, it was like we just talked about, it was the weight.
Okay.
I needed something which was big, heavy, thick body. Mm-hmm. I'm a rhythm player, and I like resonance. I like feel. Right. I like to dig in hard with my right hand. And that's why the dimensions are like they are on that, and that obviously helps towards my sound.
And that's a good point. A lot of times when you see a signature series guitar, a lot of people may think it's more cosmetic than anything else, mm-hmm. but it's also what's under the hood. The weight of that guitar has a real nice weight, and as we know, when you have a dense wood, it's sustain. You know, it yeah. plays much differently. You get a lot more sustain, and you get that feel.
Mm-hmm.
You know, big, thick neck, heavy weighted body.
Yeah, I mean, being in this area, like when we're on, mm-hmm. is brutal. Just the weight of the sound. Obviously, we've got great amps and stuff,
right?
But the guitar is, you know, essentially is what is pumping that sound out. You know what I mean?
Right.
And it's brutal behind here.
As they say with tires, it's, you know, where the rubber meets the road. I mean, that's
exactly.
between you and everything else.
Yeah, exactly. That's what counts. You know, it all helps, but that's priority. You know.
Nice. Even though Bullet could be heavy, there's a ton of melody going on. Is it hard for you to find a balance between the heavy grind of guitars while keeping your vocals melodic?
No, it's a formula that we've always just kind of done.
Mm-hmm.
There was no thought, you know, even in the early days when we were just writing our first kind of songs, that was just what was happening.
Right.
So I think it was just kind of growing up with a lot of heavy influences, but also growing up loving songs, loving a bit more kind of the songwriting, big choruses, that kind of thing. So everything from Slayer and Testament to Bon Jovi and Bruce Springsteen and stuff, you
right.
know what I mean? So I think that's just kind of what we do.
So some of your favorite bands were Metallica, you had mentioned Bruce mm-hmm. Springsteen.
Yeah.
What are the favorite bands of yours?
There was Pantera, Slayer, Machine Head. there was tons. Sepultura.
Mm-hmm.
There was kind of that mid-90s kind of like thrash metal stuff.
Was there one song or one video in particular that you watched that made you want to pick up a guitar and play?
There was probably two. I'll say the other one, which because I've never really said it before. There was it was on MTV Headbangers Ball in about 1994, 95, and I was about 15 years old or whatever. Just started to get into music, so I started watching Headbangers Ball,
mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
and Pantera came on playing Domination live from Moscow, I think.
Okay.
And it was just like, what is this? You know, because I didn't really know who Pantera were, and it was my first kind of experience of Pantera and Dimebag, and just, you know, that song in particular, and just in front of like 300,000 people, wherever it was just like, all right, this is me.
So that was an adrenaline shot of inspiration for you.
Yeah, and honestly, moments like that are like to find. Even at a very early age, like 14, 15, it was like, this is me.
Mm-hmm.
That's it, that's all I'm doing.